So, you asked, I deliver. In this video, we're going to dive into getting two Xbox controllers working on PC. Now, we're going to do two different methods. One is going to be the Xbox 360 controller emulator, just to show you how you can plug in actually two controllers. This works for any other combination. Two Xbox controllers, two PS4 controllers, PS4 and PS5, what you call it. The other method that we're going to go ahead and approach is actually setting it up with the Steam configuration, which also works pretty well, but it's confined to Steam usage. Okay, so the first one is actually a normal Xbox controller, which also has compatibility with PC. You can use a micro USB cable. And then the other controller we're going to be using is the Xbox wireless controller for PC, which is a fancier version. This is actually the new release, which has their D-pad similar to the Elite controller, but it's less elite. And this one actually uses a USB-C cable or USB-C connector. So we'll be able to plug both of those using the Xbox 360 emulator and also trying it out with the Steam configuration. Okay, so let's go ahead and dive into our computer right away and set this up. So as you can see, both controllers are detected by Windows. It's an Xbox controller, so it should work on Windows. Anyways, so now that we have our two controllers connected. Now the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna hop into the game folder. So as you know, we can right click on the game, go to manage, and then we're gonna find or browse for local files. And we're gonna go ahead and load our Xbox 360 emulator. Okay, so we're gonna run this as an administrator. And as we know, it will start trying to detect the configuration for our both controllers. So you know, if you want to know how to fix this problem with a misconfigured device at zero, go ahead and check the links in the description below, or you can check the cards up here, which will guide you into the next video. So first thing first, we're going to go ahead and configure the controllers to make sure that they both work and that we can record the data inputs from the controller into the computer. All right, so now we have our game controllers, both of them, the Xbox wireless, let's call it carbon black, and let's call it robot white. So now we have both controllers already plugged into the computer, they're already configured. As you know, what we like to do here, you can go ahead and set this up. You can either use the record option, or if that is too complicated or you don't have any time for that, just go ahead and check in the description below. There's a link to download the configuration for both controllers plugged into the Xbox 360 emulator. Now from here, as you know, right, we're gonna make sure that all both controllers work, right? And now we can go ahead and save. Now the most important thing here when we're setting this up is that you have controller one and controller two. As you notice, it actually automatically detects both controllers. That's all you need to do. And now that we have our two Xbox wireless controllers plugged into the computer, we're gonna go ahead and make sure that we have the proper DLL file for the Xbox 360 emulator. Also, you can go ahead and check the playlist up here, which has all type of controllers that you can plug into your computer and set it up with the Xbox 360 emulator. And I also do this through stream. By the way, talking about streaming, I stream on twitch.tv/edio4tv every single week. Just go ahead and check the link in the description below. Now that we have finished, we can go ahead and close the Xbox 360 controller emulator. And as you know, we just need to go ahead and start our game. Now, as you know, what we like to test is go ahead and just press a button during the loading screen, and that should go ahead and skip the game load and just get you into the initial loading screen. There you go. And this is using the second controller, which is supposed to be controller 2, the robot Y controller. But I can also go into my carbon black controller and load it in. Now the fun part of this is that you can actually go to free battle and you can choose two players, and this would automatically detect that these two controllers are either controller 1 and controller 2. So now I'm going to choose my characters and I'm going to go ahead and take controller 2, which is the robot Y controller, and I'm going to press start. Now for method number two, we can go ahead and dive into the Steam platform. And as you know, we're gonna go ahead and open Big Picture. I know, I think another viewer said that this is actually the only good reason why we wanna load Big Picture. I finally gave somebody a reason to open Big Picture on Steam. I mean, it works. So what you wanna do is go all the way up here to the right corner on the gear and then go to controller settings. Okay, so what you wanna do is go ahead and enable the Xbox configuration support, as you can see here. So it's gonna be really straightforward. After you get here, you can notice that you have two detector controllers, which are both of them Xbox One controllers. And the only thing that you need to do here is actually come here and enable the Xbox configuration support. Now, you don't really need to enable the Xbox extended feature support. That is if you have some Elite controllers. These are not Elite controllers, so I won't be using the additional paddles that go in the back. I'm gonna leave it as it is, just press B for back. And that's about it. So if I go right away into my library and look for my game, I should be able to load that game. And because I already enabled the Xbox controller configuration support, they both should work. Set up two controllers. And now I'm gonna go to my second controller, press start, and I can choose my character. And there you got it. Now you know how to set up your Xbox 360 controllers for two players on PC. Now, why would I want to use the X360 controller emulator instead of using Steam? Well, that depends on your needs, right? If you have games on Steam, cool, go ahead. By all means, go ahead and set it up with that way. But if you don't have games on Steam or you don't want to use Steam, right? Then you can go ahead and use the X360 controller emulator. Don't forget to go ahead and smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and click on the notification bell so you can be notified whenever I release a brand new video. This was Eddie04. See you on the next one. Peace.